Dear friends, we've been through a lot in the last couple months, and there's cause for rejoicing. School's back on, we're able to worship here, and today we're celebrating 75 years of being able to worship in this beautiful church. So 75 years ago today, August 30th, 1945, this church was dedicated and became a place of worship through which we've received the sacraments, God's life for us, the last 75 years, and that Mass was first celebrated in what was the old high altar, and since then, what a beautiful gift we've been able to receive our Lord and the many great sacraments that are offered through these very walls. I was ordained here in 2009, so there's cause for rejoicing, and I figured since this will be our 75th anniversary year and then beyond, and then the parish shortly thereafter, and I'll tell you more about that coming up, we're going to celebrate, though, 75 years of this beautiful church building, the cathedral, which is the bishop's church. It's the principal church of the diocese, and 75 years shortly of our parish family from the moment that it was established here, and it's been gathering here for 75 years. So I thought, why don't we do, and I'm going to take a page out of our good friend Bishop Vetter's book, and do a little virtual church tour to show you maybe some up close things that normally you don't get a chance to see. And we're starting right here. We'll start with the baptismal font. You can see there's an inscription. Perhaps some of you have seen it in the past. Now we've got a nice light on it, and you can see there are two fish. And if you look real closely, you'll see that there's another fish in the inside. And this is actually what looks like a basket, is a net. Some in antiquity, sometimes the fishing nets were actually baskets. And I think even parts of the world today, they still are. So what's that all about? This baptismal font and the significance of these fish. Well, first of all, the fish represent Christ, and they represent then the baptized. Because what happens here, and by the way, 75 years ago, we actually have a record. It's in this beautiful, on September 2nd, so just a few days after the dedication of this church building, Kelly Lee Hansen and Catherine Lynn Hansen were baptized twin baby girls, were the first two to be baptized in this font. And so what happened to them that day, and we hope they're doing well, what happened to them that day is they became like Christ, configured to Christ. And as you may recall from catechism class, the old symbol of ichthus, which is the Greek word for fish. So that was the symbol of Christ during times when the persecution, so you could communicate who you were, even if it wasn't popular or if it was dangerous. And it stands for Jesus Christos, Jesus Christ, Theou, which means God, Huius, which means son, and soter, which means savior. So they found this creative way to use the word for, in Greek, for fish, to say who Jesus is. Jesus, the anointed one, who is God, who is the Son of the Father, second person of the Trinity, and savior. So, and when you see fish, we gotta think Jesus. And whoever is baptized in this very font takes on Christ, or clothed with Christ, and so we become little Christ. And that's our whole goal, is to live our lives like him. But you see, there are also other fish in here. And so what is the significance of these other fish? That are all the members. It's all the members of the church. And we can think of the Gospel of John, chapter 21, the miraculous catch after the resurrection. They're fishing all night. Things aren't working. Jesus appears to them. They don't know who it is yet on the shores. He said, try the other side. And they throw it in. They have this miraculous catch of fish. They say 153, which is be symbolic of all the species of fish probably that they knew at the time. It meant everyone is available, grace is available to everyone, and that symbolizes then all of the baptized. And the net, as you can see here, is the church. So how beautiful, all the fish being gathered together in the church through which we receive the great gifts of grace, the sacraments. So here we are at this font. This is the original top from 1945. We found it in storage, and it was in good shape, so we're able to use it. And we've had already a couple baptisms in this new configuration. So there we are, our baptismal font. A little bit of theology that we become like Christ as our sins are washed away. And then you'll see that we'll also use a seashell sometimes when we baptize here. That's symbolic of St. James, who was known to baptize thousands in Spain with a seashell. Also that image with the water and the fish and the seashell, it's all quite beautiful. So there you have it, just a little virtual church tour on this beautiful little space. And we've got more things coming in this exciting year and a half of celebrating 75 years of the church, and then very soon of our parish We're going to have a 40 hours devotion coming up in November, a week before Thanksgiving. We'll tell you more about that. Spirit Fest, can't wait to have that back, hopefully next spring or early summer. And then maybe if we wrap everything up in a year and a half or so, if things look good for us, maybe we'll go to Rome. How does that sound? But anyway, more virtual church tours will be coming your way. Happy 75th anniversary to this beautiful building and to our parish family. And we'll say more about that in the future. God bless you.